Hi everyone, welcome back to Pages of the Globe. Today I'm going to be reading to you the short story, A Strange Story, by O. Henry. Now, O. Henry is a very, very popular author, and you've probably heard of him many times. He was an American writer. His actual name is William Sidney Porter, but he's better known by his pen name, O. Henry. And he's primarily known for his short stories, but he's written poetry and nonfiction. And some of his most famous works that you probably could recognize would be The Gift of the Magi, The Duplicity of Hargreaves, and The Ransom of the Red Chief, as well as the novel Cabbages and Kings. The reason, or at least one of the reasons, that O. Henry is just so popular is because his stories are just like, they are known for their like naturalist observations, and they always have like surprise endings and really witty narration. And his legacy includes the O. Henry Award, which is an annual prize awarded to outstanding short stories. Now, the actual story, A Strange Story, is about being a patient, and it's about how it's honestly a very odd account of a delayed errand for cough syrup requiring patience. Coincidentally, two, in fact. That's a really short story, and I don't want to give it away, so let's get started. Remember to like, share, subscribe, and comment down below which short story you would like to hear next. In the northern part of Austin, there once dwelt an honest family by the name of Smothers. The family consisted of John Smothers, his wife, himself, their little daughter, 5 years of age, and her parents, making 6 people toward the population of the city when counted for a special write-up, but only 3 by actual count. One night after supper, the little girl was seized by a severe colic, and John Smothers hurried downtown to get some medicine. He never came back. The little girl recovered and in time grew up to womanhood. The mother grieved very much over her husband's disappearance, and it was nearly 3 months before she married again and moved to San Antonio. The little girl also got married in time, and after a few years had rolled around, she also had a little girl 5 years of age. She still lived in the same house where they dwelt when her father had left and never returned. One night, by remarkable coincidence, her little girl was taken by cramp colic on the anniversary of the disappearance of John Smothers, who would now have been her grandfather if he had been alive and had a steady job. "I will go downtown and get some medicine for her," said John Smith, for it was none other than he whom she married. "No, no, no, dear John," cried his wife. "You too might disappear forever and then forget to come back." So John Smith did not go, and together they sat beside the little Pansy, for that was Pansy's name. After a little, Pansy seemed to grow worse, and John Smith again attempted to go for medicine, but his wife would not let him. Suddenly, the door opened, and an old man stooped and bent with long white hair entered the room. "Hello, here's Grandpa," said Pansy. She had recognized him before any of the others. The old man drew a bottle of medicine from his pocket and gave Pansy a spoonful. She got well immediately. "I was a little late," said John Smothers, "as I waited for a streetcar." The end.